in Cecil, Wisconsin, and welcome to the beginning of our celebration of the Triduum. You know, I'm happy if you found us and you're watching us live, I'm happy that you're here because of some of the miscommunication we're having and some of the troubles we're having with trying to do live Mass. And I invite you now to enter into worship of our Lord Jesus Christ and celebrate with him these 3 days of days till his journey to Easter.
Today we begin our celebration of Easter Triduum, the 3 days that form the climax of Jesus' life on earth. Knowing that he is about to die, Jesus takes the opportunity at the Last Supper not only to tell the disciples what to do in the future, but to show them. As we celebrate, let us reflect on how we can become better disciples by serving others. Our gathering song is Table of Plenty, number 311.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
participate in the most sacred supper in which your only begotten Son was about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, that this month every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one, and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old, male, and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand, you shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh.
first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body, that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him. So, during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with a towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you,
Lord
Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Father Adam Bradley. I'm the Assistant Vocation Director for the Diocese of Green Bay, and it is a joy to come out here to Cecil to celebrate the Triduum with all of you. Today's Gospel, we have Jesus instituting the Eucharist, we have Jesus instituting the priesthood, we have Jesus having this dialogue with his friend Peter. And he tells Peter that he is going to wash his feet. Peter begins by saying, or by asking him if he's going to wash his feet, and he says that you will never wash my feet. And Jesus says, unless you are clean, you have no inheritance with me. And one of the things that we have to remember is throughout all of our lives, we all have a tendency to not permit the Lord to and to serve us in the way that he desires to love us and to serve us. One of the things we have a tendency to forget is that throughout all time and history, God desires to be with you. He created you so that he could have a unique relationship with you. And one of the ways in which he desires to be with you is through the gift of himself in the body, blood, soul, and divinity of the Eucharist. God makes himself eternally and immediately present to us in the sacraments of the altar. He even goes so far as to spend his days waiting for you in a little gold box called a tabernacle, where he desires to remain with you. Where he desires you to come and to be with him. God of the infinite universe desires a relationship. He saw that creating you was the greatest thing for the world, that in a specific place, in a specific time, he called you into existence. And he loved that part of his will so much that it's actually that love that is holding you in existence. And it's in that same love that welcomed you into the church at your baptism. It's that same love that permits the priest to act the Eucharist in his hands so that Jesus can, in a very intimate way, be with you. A lot of times we have a tendency throughout our lives to get bogged down by our sins or things from our past that tend to take our peace away, or future that we allow to again take our peace away, and we remain with the Lord. And if we take just a second of our lives, and just take this moment right now, don't worry about the future, don't worry about the past, just right here, this moment, God is immediately present to you. Whether you feel that's the case or not, your feelings actually don't dictate. Attention to Jesus' love for us in the present moment, what we find is our lives aren't tailspinning into the ground. The things in the present moment tend to be okay. God is a God of the future, and he's a God of the past, but the only place where you are is right here, right now, in the present moment. So the only place where you can receive the immense love that God has for you is right here in this moment. And it's in today's gospel that Jesus has made himself abundantly available to his disciples. So the fact where he's washing their feet, and they don't, Peter doesn't want to, because on some level, realizes he's the Son of God and thinks that that is below God to wash his feet. What we fail to realize is God doesn't need us, but he wants us. He wants to be with you. He wants those areas of our lives that are broken and need to be cleansed sometimes even more deeply than you want them. Because God doesn't want anything that would prevent us from coming to Him. God wants those broken areas of our lives to be an area that when we go there isn't an area of pain and suffering anymore, but is an area where His love is made known deeply and personally. So that area is no longer an area of pain, but an area where you point to in your life. You can say, God loved me here. And part of permitting that, part of allowing into our lives in a deeper way, is we have to go in silence. Everything grows in silence. You don't hear flowers in a garden growing. You don't hear trees in the woods growing. You don't hear people as they grow. And our souls, and the love that God has for us, we permit to grow within us in silence. God desires a very deep and intimate relationship with you. This relationship that He wants to have with you doesn't start like normal human relationships. Most human relationships start very superficial. You start talking about the weather. You start talking about how your day was. You start talking about what sports teams you like. You start talking very superficial things. You talk about deeper things, what you like, what you dislike, what you find joy in. And with two people who love each other, they begin to reveal a deeper part of their heart to one another to the point where they fall in love and eventually get married. God doesn't start superficially. God starts at the very core of who you are because He created every facet of you. So He meets you at the very depths of your soul. And He begins to invite you to a transformation. A word for this transformation is called conversion, and it's something that we all have to go through, including bishops, priests, cardinals. Everyone needs conversion. And it's at the very depths of our heart when we permit the Lord in silence to begin to reveal the greatness that He desires you to accomplish in this life. That is when we begin to know God's love for us. Is when we permit Him to reveal it. Is when we give Him the time and the permission to love us. Particularly when we do not feel lovable. You see, when Peter was sitting there and he was telling Jesus, "No, you will never wash my feet." There's almost a, keep an arm's length away from me in this part because this part of me is not worthy. And Christ says, unless I make this clean, make this area of your life worthy, you have no inheritance with me. Because you're not permitting me to love you. Because everything happens through the love of God. Our baptism, we're welcomed into the church by the love of God. Through the love of God given to us through the gift of the sacrament of holy orders, we have the Eucharist, the supreme example of love. God giving us Him very self in a way that we can actually consume Him. It's that same love that forgives us of our sins and heals us of our brokenness and of our wounds. And it's that same love that the Lord desires you to live in on this earth until you are safely with Him, please Jesus, at the end of our lives. The only question left unanswered is, will you permit Him? Will you permit Him to love you the way that He desires to love you, which is perfectly? Will He allow Him to love you through the Eucharist? Will you come and visit Him and allow Him to tell you what great lengths He went to win you back? And what deep desire He has for you to be with Him in heaven forever? Will you let Him? So as we go throughout this Triduum, tonight we celebrate the institution of the priesthood, of the Eucharist, and we know that tonight also Jesus is betrayed and his passion begins. Will you follow him? And let him show you throughout these next 3 days the immense and personal and infinite and unique love that he has for you. This is a question that I can't answer for you. Nobody else can. So, as we can see, as we begin this Triduum journey, let us always ask the Lord in a deeper way to reveal his love to our hearts so that we can respond with a resounding, a firm, and an eternal. Hearts filled with faith, let us offer our petitions to the Father.
For the Holy Father, Pope Francis, for our Bishop, Bishop David, and all priests, deacons, and bishops, and all who lead others to a personal relationship with Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the nations of the world, that they make correct decisions for their citizens during this time of trial, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick with the coronavirus, but also for those who are sick with many other diseases, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the doctors, nurses, first responders, and themselves in harm's way to serve others, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially those who are members of St. Martin of Tours Parish, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please join me in the prayer to St. Joseph. Good St. Joseph,
as you led the Holy Family, watch over our families. Help our family and all families to know and share God's love. In our family relationships, may we find and seek to be holy. May our fathers help us to become faithful disciples of
Jesus who
share our love for him. As foster father of Jesus, watch over all who serve as spiritual fathers. In a special way, bless our Holy Father, our bishop, and our priests. May they follow your humble example in their fatherly care for the people of the church. With Mary, you raise Jesus the High Priest. You know our need for priests. Please raise good and holy priests from our families to serve the people of our diocese. May our children and grandchildren say yes to the call of Jesus, just as you and Mary did. Good St. Joseph, pray for us.
Heavenly Father, we ask that you hear all of these prayers and ask them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
of the sacrifice at your hands,
for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern and everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim. Commanding us to offer in his memorial, as we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong, and as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
God, we pray to bless the knowledge and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritually acceptable so it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, for the salvation and the salvation of all that is. Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, given up for you. Similar way, when Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, to their Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Please join me in the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and a desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.